Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Sam in Vienna. Sam has a schedule of all of his classes, and you see that there are some days where Sam does not have class. So there was no class on August 26th. And he said, everywhere where there's not a class on that day, he'd like to insert a blank row so that way he could, you know, make notes of, maybe what he's going to do that day or something like that. And so initially I thought, okay, we're going to build a little table out on the right hand side with all the dates, do vlookups to bring this data over, and then switch the NAs to blanks or something like that. But the thing that kind of screwed that idea up is you see that here on the 27th of August, there are two classes, one at 10 a.m. and one at 2:30. So that's not going to work at all. So now here's my second approach to this. I'm going to come over here and put in the first day's date, 8/24/2009, and I'm going to figure out what the last day is. So we'll scroll down, January 14th. I just grab the fill handle so we can build all these dates down to January 14th. This is a list of all the dates that could possibly happen. And then I'm going to use the match command. I'm going to come over here and say, build a column called there. Equal match. Go look for this date within this range of dates over here. Control shift down arrow. Press F4 to lock that down. Comma 0 saying we want an exact match. And wow, that's giving me a date. That's kind of funny. I really don't care about the results. What I really care about are the NAs. So this is a 1. This is a 2. That's telling me what row number it's on. Really don't care there. I really just care about the NAs. Let's convert those to values. And now we're going to sort descending. Sort descending, that'll bring all of the NAs to the top. There we have it. Those are all the dates that have no match over on the left-hand side. So I'll take those dates, come down here, and just paste it below my data, ESV. I'm going to take this date format, a very clever date format, EST for formats. And now we get our dates in there. And we'll delete these extra columns, those temporary columns over there. Now, what I think we can do is come back here and sort by the start date. Click A to Z. Let's see what happens. There it is. There are now blank rows for all of the cells. Much easier than going through and individually inserting the rows. Just come out to the right-hand side, figure out what dates we're missing, and then allow the power of the sort to bring those right up into the proper spots. Looks like, so here on December 11th, we have two rows. That's good because there were two classes. But then on all of the other days where there were no dates, works out pretty well. Hey, thanks to Sam for sending in that question. Sam says he watches the podcast every day all the way from Vienna. Very cool. You know, another question, and this is the thing that initially caught my eye, is I opened this up on the U.S. version of Excel, but we're still getting a foreign date version there. When I go into Control 1, let's just see what... wow, can't explain that, how we're getting another language there for the day of the week. Let's check out custom. Oh, it must be that country code there, C07, DDDDD. Interesting. Never knew that you could do that. Not sure why you'd want to, but there you have it. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.